Hello, today we'll discuss about atomic spectra. One important aspect in atomic spectra we are going to study today, that's about Thomson's experiment on the determination of E by M of electrons, that is charge to mass ratio. E stands for charge, M stands for mass. So E divided by M is called specific charge or E by M of electrons. Now let us see how this important characteristics of electrons was determined by J.J. Thomson. We all know that the present era is known as the technology era, and this technology era is mainly based on the electronics, or it's dependent on electronics. Most of the technological aspects are deeply rooted in electronics. Now, what is electronics? Electronics is nothing but the study of electrons, or the study of flow of electrons under controlled manner. So it's all about electrons. But do you know, these electrons were discovered just 123 years back. Even cricket was known to man much before that. So in the year 1897, British physicist J.J. Thomson discovered electrons. J.J. Thomson not only discovered electrons, but also he studied some of its important properties, especially its charge to mass ratio is one of the very important properties of electrons. The charge of the electron is very important characteristics. It's one of the elementary particles having a unit charge or basic charge. And its charge to mass ratio was determined by J.J. Thomson himself way back in 1897. Now, let us study the experiment performed by J.J. Thomson to determine this E by M of electrons. Now, there is another interesting aspect of scientist. We have a very beautiful analogy between a common man and a scientist. How do they think? How do they work? For example, if you have got a closed box which is locked and the key is lost, and you have the curiosity to see what is there inside the box, what do you do? You go for certain tools, maybe hammer or a screwdriver or a cutting plier. You make use of these tools and you break open the box and see what is there inside the box to quench your curiosity. Similarly, the scientist, they always try to explore this nature. They want to see what is the secret of this nature. They try to break open the secret or mystery of this nature. And for this, they make use of certain tools like magnet or magnetic field, electricity or electric field, very high temperature, very low temperature, etc., etc. So even scientists make use of certain tools which are scientifically supported and explore this nature. Similarly, in this case also, J.J. Thomson made use of electric field and magnetic field to study the property of electrons. Now let us see the principle behind the determination of E by M of electron by Thomson's method. As you know, in the year 1897, J.J. Thomson discovered electrons, and thereafter he found the ratio between the charge of the electron and its mass. At that time, when these electrons were discovered in the early years, they were known as cathode rays or cathode ray particles because they were originated from the cathode of a gas discharge tube. So E by m of the electrons is given by the ratio between charge of the electron and mass of the electron. So as I already mentioned, J.J. Thomson made use of the electric field and magnetic field to determine E by m of the electrons. To understand it more clearly, now let us see the action of this electric field and action of this magnetic field on moving charges like electrons. What happens when these electrons are subjected to electric field? What happens to these electrons when they apply subjected to magnetic field? Whenever an electric field is applied on a moving charge, the charge will experience a force. Whenever a magnetic field is applied on a moving charge, the charge will experience a force. And what is the nature of this force? What is the magnitude of this force? What is the direction of this force? We'll study now. So first we'll see what is the action of an electric field on a moving charge or motion of a charged particle in an electric field. The charged particle moving in an electric field experiences a force, and the magnitude of this force is given by the product of the magnitude of the charge and the electric field. So F is equal to E into capital E, where small e is the magnitude of the charge, capital E the strength of the electric field. And about the direction of the force is along the direction of the field in the case of a positive charge, and the direction of the force is opposite to the direction of the field in the case of a negative charge. So in the case of an electron, the force is in a direction opposite to the direction of the motion of the electron. In the case of a proton or a positron, the direction of the force is same as the direction of motion of the positron or proton. So we'll discuss more about these aspects in the next session, that is the effect of magnetic field on the moving charge and the detailed theory of the E by M experiment.